Hey, here are 5 things you must look out for before you say yes, I do to anyone. Number 1 is originality. You know, today we are very familiar with the term fake people, you know, pretenders, or in other words, hypocrites. You must be able to attest that whoever you're dealing with has shown you their true self, the original self, and you know everything, at least for the most part, that there is to know. Some time ago, a lady came to me and was complaining that she wasn't understanding why the man she had married had left her for another woman. And the sad thing was, this was not the first time it was happening to her. And so she thought maybe there was a problem with her. And she was like, this man came to church, he did water baptism, he prayed, and he went through Bible school and all of that. And so my question was, did he go through Bible school because he loved the Lord and wanted to know the Lord more? Or because you placed baptism and Bible school as a condition or a prerequisite for him to have access to you? You see, today, people, as far as love is concerned, they are going to do whatsoever it takes just to have access to you. And once they have had access to you, well, they can give themselves the freedom now to reveal your true colors. And usually, that is too late. So, well, how can you attest someone is being truthful, someone is being open, someone is being original? You don't want to get married and you realize she had 3 kids sometimes back, or he had some other secret. The thing about originality is not saying that people have to be perfect, because you might be watching this and you've actually been putting on a mask so that you can win someone else's heart. But, well, I hope you can learn that from today. The thing about originality is not that you should be perfect, but it's that you should be able to reveal every truth so that the person getting in knows what you're getting into. Because once you know what you're going in for, then you prepare yourself mentally, emotionally, psychologically, then to have unpleasant surprises. And the next one, number 2, is the center of focus. Before you say yes, I do, you want to know what is at the center of this person's focus. The Bible teaches believers that Christ and the pursuit of God's kingdom should be at the center of our focus. You have to know that once you say yes, I do, it's for life. And so you want to know that whatever you are doing now, like your center of focus, that's going to be your center of focus till death do you part. If Christ isn't the center of focus, but rather the flesh, carnality, whatever you can enjoy now and the world, then you might want to start reconsidering or seeing to it that you address that issue before it's too late. And the third thing you want to look out for is the life priorities. What are the person's priorities? It may sound strange, but you might be with someone who is actually prioritizing you over themselves. As flattering as that may be, it's very dangerous, because they may not just be doing that to you, they may be doing that to others, because there are people who have committed themselves to want to please others at the expense of pleasing themselves. Because this is a proper lineup of priorities in everyone's life. Number 1 is God. Relationship with God is the first priority. The second priority is yourself, your mental health, your emotional health, your physical health. Now, the third priority is your marriage or your spouse, the person now you're dealing with. And later on in marriage, when they are children, they also qualify in that third priority. Then the fourth priority now is work, purpose, ministry, whatsoever you were born to do. And the fifth priority is the church, meaning the world, the people you're reaching out to, and those around you. Several relationships end bitterly because priorities weren't put straight. Either people prioritize work over the home and the family, or they prioritize the ministry over the home and the family, or they prioritize themselves and their personal interests over their relationship with God. And the fourth thing is the fear of God. This is perhaps even the most important one on this list, because no matter how you know someone, there are always things you only find out after you're married. So how do you know this person is not going to cheat on you? How do you know this person is not going to wake up one day and beat you up or leave you or whatsoever evil we see in the world today? That thing is the fear of God. Because when someone fears God, there are things they won't do to you. It's not because they love you or something, not necessarily. Even in friendships, it's not every day that you're in good terms with your friends. And likewise in marriage or in any relationship, there may be times you'll be at odds, but there are things you would restrain yourself from doing. Not because you love the person, perhaps because at that point in time, the person is very unlovable and they might even deserve whatever punishment or rash reaction you want to take. But because you fear God, there are things you won't do. So you want to check, is the fear of God in place? And the last one has 2 parts. The first part is work for men. I know we are entering a modern age now, and we call it the Android generation, where things are a little bit being re-questioned, redefined and changed. And so today you actually have women who are able to meet ends need and even provide for the home. But it has been proven over and over again that any relationship where the man is idle, lazy and not doing anything, even if the woman is able to stress-free provide everything, at one point she is always going to be disturbed, wondering if she's now the man in the family or she's the woman. And then worse is when she's actually struggling to make ends meet. She just gets exasperated, and that is the beginning of disrespect. The one thing the man needs most from her, that submission, he begins to lose it because of that idleness or laziness. And the second part is sound character or attitude for women. You need to understand that the beauty and the features, in quotes, of the woman may attract you. But after all the euphoria and excitement of a new relationship is over, or even when age kicks in, then it's the character and attitude of that woman that the man will have to live on with. So you just don't want to look at the physical attribute, but you want to look at the core, because that is what is going to last far longer. The beauty, the physical things, they'll wear out with time, but character, that's what stands. So those are my 5 things that you should look out for before you say yes, I do to anyone. I think you might have others that you think should be on this list. I would like to see your own list in the comments below. Any other points you want to add, or based on your experience and whatsoever you've learned, please share in the comments below so that we too can learn from you. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you're new to this channel, subscribe and click that bell so you don't miss our next video. I'm Brother Jumesi from Wisdom for Dominion. A big shout out to all our patrons. Thank you so much for supporting our work. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next video. That's our time in this video. I don't believe you were inspired by it. Then give it a thumbs up and subscribe if you're new to this channel for more great content like this. Remember to take responsibility on what you learned today. This video is proudly sponsored by our patrons. You too can support this channel by visiting our Patreon page. The link is in the video description below. I want to say a big thank you to all our patrons out there. I am Brother Jumesi from Wisdom for Dominion. Thank you for watching, and see you in our next video.